In today's Gospel from Matthew chapter 13, we hear the famous parable of the sower who went out to sow his seed, and how it fell on different types of ground, thus yielding very different results. Hello, I'm Father James Kubicki, and this is one of those parables that we've heard so often, we tend to glaze over and not really hear it anymore. But in the first volume of his book, Jesus of Nazareth, Pope Benedict made an important point about the seed that is sown. In this parable, it is a symbol of the Word of God that is proclaimed and either rejected, ignored, forgotten, or received. But remember how John's Gospel begins? The Word is not just a spoken Word, but Jesus Himself. Thus, Pope Benedict wrote that in chapter 12 of John, Jesus said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and it dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit." Then Pope Benedict goes on to say that Jesus, quote, "Himself is the grain of wheat. His failure on the cross is exactly the way leading from the few to the many, to all. And when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all men to myself." In the parables, Jesus is not only the sower who scatters the seed of God's word, but also the seed that falls into the earth in order to die and so bear much fruit. End quote. This makes sense. When we approach the gospel, we're not just reading about Jesus, but actually encountering Jesus, the Word who was made flesh and who continues to speak to us. So, no matter how many times you've heard a particular parable or gospel story, listen. Jesus is speaking to you. And though you may have heard what he's had to say before, be ready for him to say something new. Because, as the letter to the Hebrews put it, the Word of God is living and effective.